Hello, friends. Hope you had a great weekend and you're having a good time. We have two updates to share regarding SpaceX and one from China. So, get set, go. SpaceX is making excellent progress on its project to colonize Mars, which they clearly proved with the test fire of their vacuum Raptor engine. On Friday, September 25th, company representatives posted a video on their official Twitter page that shows their new vacuum Raptor engine completing a full-duration test fire at the company's rocket development facility. The video also hinted that the company's upcoming Starship development work is in high pace. The test fire of the first vacuum Raptor engine at their rocket test facility in McGregor, Texas. The new in-space version of SpaceX's vacuum Raptor engine will be added to the upcoming SpaceX Starship prototypes. According to the information, with the help of this powerful Raptor engine, the SpaceX Starship could get through the vacuum of space. The vacuum Raptor engine was shifted to McGregor from SpaceX's Los Angeles rocket factory just 3 weeks before the engine shot fire on its debut test. Unlike the smaller sea-level variants, which have been tested so far, this new variant of SpaceX Raptor engine is totally on a different level in case of both height and power. Previously, SpaceX posted a photo which showed the new vacuum SpaceX Raptor towering over the previous one. The new vacuum Raptor is relatively bigger than the previous one. The bigger look is provided by the big nozzle that new SpaceX Raptor offers. Having a bigger nozzle improves the efficiency in the space environment. Friday's post showed the video lasted for at least 15 seconds, although SpaceX stated that the test as full duration, so without the actual confirmation from the company, it's difficult to predict the lifespan of the test. At the end of the video, we can hear the vacuum Raptor engine is still going strong. According to SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, the original Starship will have three of each Raptor variant. Therefore, a total of six SpaceX Raptors will power the 165-foot tall or 50-meter SpaceX Starship to travel through space. The vehicle will be powerful enough to perform the liftoff by using those Raptor engines. More power will be needed while escaping Earth's deep gravity. Thus, SpaceX Starship will be launched atop the giant rocket called Super Heavy. The Super Heavy itself will be powered by 28 sea-level SpaceX Raptor engines. Previously, the company decided that the Super Heavy will have 37 sea-level engines, but soon they crunched the numbers to 28. Both SpaceX's Starship and Super Heavy will have a serious amount of firepower to meet its goal. The new vacuum SpaceX Raptor engine is an important stage in Musk's vision of sending people on Mars. The vacuum Raptor will power SpaceX's upcoming Starship, which they're currently developing at Boca Chica facility. According to Musk, SpaceX Super Heavy and Starship both will be completely and rapidly reusable. The duo of Super Heavy rocket and Starship will be about 400 meters tall. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk envisions that the duo will bring a revolution to this industry with providing more comfortable and budget-friendly rides. Thus, planetary travel will become economically feasible. Musk plans to send the first humans to Mars by the end of 2022 and build a small city on the Martian surface as early as 2050. The video clip of the vacuum Raptor engine shows impressive shock diamonds, also known as Mach diamonds, during the test fire. This phenomenon is nothing but a formation of standing wave patterns that appear in the supersonic exhaust plume of a rocket engine. A mismatch between the gases that come out of the rocket engine and the surrounding atmosphere from these shock diamonds. According to the mechanics, these shock diamonds are formed behind jet engines, ramjet, and also possible to make via a home experiment. Seeing that video, one might think the engine looks very powerful. Now there's a way to find it by measuring the amount of movement the engine creates from each unit of fuel. According to the scientists of NASA's Glenn Research Center, the figure coming from the specific impulse of the engine is notable, but it will be measured in seconds like SpaceX's Merlin engine. SpaceX's Merlin engine that's currently being used in its current Falcon 9 launches had a specific impulse of 282 seconds for the sea level and specific impulse of around 311 seconds in case of the vacuum. Last year, Musk said on Twitter that the sea level SpaceX Raptor engine has a specific impulse of around 350 seconds, which could increase up to 380 seconds for the vacuum-optimized SpaceX Raptor variant. Last but not least, SpaceX is now making progress through every test of Starship prototypes. Previously, SpaceX's SN5 and SN6 already made it to 150 meters or 500 feet from the ground, although these tests were conducted by only a single SpaceX Raptor engine. Now, SpaceX's upcoming SN8 is geared up to reach to 20 kilometers, 12 miles high, by using 3 SpaceX Raptor engines. SpaceX is also planning to take an orbital test in the next year, and then it will set its goal towards planetary travel like the Moon, Mars, etc. SpaceX has achieved another success in its launch program, as the company can now launch used rockets to carry out national security satellites. Recently, the private aerospace company has signed a contract with the U.S. Space Force to launch the upcoming GPS satellite launches under the National Security Space Launch Mission. Although the exact date hasn't fixed yet, but it's confirmed that SpaceX's Falcon 9, with its previously used first stage, will carry a GPS-3 satellite to orbit under the National Security Space Mission in 2021. Now it's the first time in a national security mission that a rocket will fly with its previously flown first stages. According to Space Force officials, the advantage of using a reusable rocket to carry out national security payloads is that it will save nearly $52.7 million for American taxpayers. Moreover, developing a brand new rocket for the mission will cost a lot of money. SpaceX is currently focused on its Starship program, thus might not want to waste time by making unnecessary Falcon 9 rockets. According to SpaceX President and Chief Operating Officer Gwynne Shotwell, SpaceX is proud to leverage Falcon 9's flight-proven benefits and capabilities for national security space launch missions. Shotwell said in her statement on September 25th, "Our extensive experience with reuse has allowed SpaceX to continually upgrade the fleet and save significant precious tax dollars on these launches. We appreciate the effort that the U.S. Space Force invested into the evaluation and are pleased that they see the benefits of the technology." Based on SpaceX's previous launch programs, it would not be the first time to use a previously flown rocket. SpaceX previously used the first stage of its Falcon 9 rocket. SpaceX's powerful Falcon Heavy is similarly reusable, but it was only launched 3 times before. Friday's announcement not only benefits the cost of the launch, but it clearly shows that the Space Force is slowly extending its region of using reusable rocket technology in their missions. SpaceX already played a key role while working on the Crew Dragon project for the U.S. government. Now flying a reusable rocket, SpaceX will gain more trust from the U.S. Space Force. Previous news shows that SpaceX has been allowed to land its Falcon 9's first stages during GPS launches by the military branch Space and Missile Command Center, SMC. The company will then recover the boosters for other launches, which they already did on the GPS-3 SVO-3 mission in June. Now SpaceX plans to do the same for its GPS-3 SVO-4 launch that's scheduled on Tuesday, September 29th. The new contract modifications include the launches of the GPS-3 SVO-5 and GPS-3 SVO-6 satellites. Both satellites will be launched on top of SpaceX's Falcon 9s with previously used first stages, which is scheduled to take place in 2021. After successfully deploying the satellites, the first stage booster of Falcon 9 will land on the targeted site. According to Walt Lauderdale, head of SMC's Falcon Systems and Operations Division and frequent mission director, SMC's commitment to innovative partnerships and working with the commercial sector while maintaining our mission assurance posture and mission success record cannot be understated. Lauderdale also mentioned, "I'm proud of our partnership with SpaceX that allowed us to successfully negotiate contract modifications for the upcoming GPS-3 missions that will save taxpayers $52.7 million while maintaining our unprecedented record of success." That's all we had regarding SpaceX today. Let's move to China. China is ready to send the world's first asteroid mining robot into space by the end of this year. However, the miner robot will not actually do mining work in space, rather it's for a field test, a technology aimed for the eventual mining of asteroids. A private aerospace company, Origin Space, will be representing the country by launching this project. The goal is to verify and demonstrate multiple functions, such as spacecraft orbital maneuver, simulated small celestial body capture, intelligent spacecraft identification and control, according to the co-founder of Origin Space, Yuten Hong. The NEO-1 seems to launch as a secondary payload on the Chinese Long March rocket. The company expects that the NEO-1 mission can make actual progress as it's a new step in this industry. Moreover, if the project achieves success, it alone can open a trillion-dollar industry, and China will make its name as the first country to do this. The industry's already heated up as other space companies are continuously making their progress, but like before, space is still an uncharted territory. Now everything goes according to plan by launching the world's first mining robot to space. China will be close enough to write its name on the uncharted territory. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.